children's associations. Another powerful argument against compulsory education, one which is generally overlooked, is that if instruction is compulsory and the parent cannot afford to send his children to a private school or tutor and is prevented from instructing the children himself, he must send his child to a public school. In the public school will be most of the others who would not be there were it not for the universal compulsory law. This includes subnormal, uneducable children and various types of juvenile delinquents and hoodlums. Whereas the parent would prefer not to send the child to formal schooling rather than to compel him to associate with these vicious types, the state forces him to do so, with incalculably evil consequences to innocent children. Removed for part of the day from the care and supervision of the parent, the child is compelled to associate with vicious companions, and might even be influenced by them to join juvenile gangs, adopt drug addiction, etc. These are not exaggerated evils, as any reader of the current press knows, but true to the common hatred of individual superiority and distinction, the passion for levelling and enforced equality proclaims, "This is good. Let every child be forced to learn about life and be forced to associate with the lowest types of humanity." The envy and hatred toward the potentially better and superior child is apparent in this position, and underlies the argument for enforced equality and consequent suppression of superior individuality.